My first choice for the day, 1/2 ounce, this nut. I use rattles 90% of the time, unless I'm using the Hack Attack jig in clear water or swimming it and stuff. The fish use a lot more visual. Good old Premier Elite, seriously, with that little rattle, I got the 3X chunk. And want to cause more of a silhouette, you know? It's got some red flake, black, brown with black, just incredible. And sometimes when the water's murky, or you want to fish in areas that resemble crayfish and stuff, depending on what the lake color is. You go to Lake Simcoe and Lake Hootchaching and stuff, it's real clear water, those crayfish are like a white, bluish tone. But in this lake, they've got that brown, orange, almost like a black on them too, pretty unique. That resembles it to a T. When those fish see that, there's no mistaking it, they gotta eat it. Let's see if Big Papa or Big Mama is sitting amongst the hole. See, I just drop it in like that? It's a real light pitch. And I'm not working it hard, letting it fall. One shake of the rattle and down. It's almost like a crayfish making noise among the rocks and stuff. When they see that, they eat it up. See the meat? Go by the rocks. You find the rocks, that's what you find. With crayfish-oriented baits. That's what I told you, didn't I, eh? Crayfish-oriented baits, look who's got it too. First fish of the day. You know you're doing something right when you go to the second spot. Look at that, who's got it. Second spot, and you get bit. Nice chunk. I'm gonna put them in there and see what kind of limit I can get. Crayfish-oriented baits on a lake that's got lots of rocks and weed mix, but just that mix of finding out those early summer largemouth on lakes with lots of rocks. That last one pulled it out good. Push it up right to the neck of the jig so everything sits up real good and tight. There we go. Now I feel better. So I trim back that reed guard too. Normally it sits over the hook eye. I trimmed it back. There's only a few strands. It just, you know, repels off the rock, but it keeps the weeds off. Doesn't frustrate you. You just flare it a little bit like this, like that, a little fanning it. Fish bite it, does not impede it, just push it down. But largemouth are just wicked. When they want something, you can rarely pull it away from them. Now there's a rock pile. I only hit the end of it there. About 6 feet of water. Yeah, look at that. How's that, eh? Wow. He's got some friends with him. Just hasn't got that 6-pounder with him. But I'm telling you, I don't want to put him back right away here because I'll tell you why. He's small. Well, you know what I'm going to do? Put him at the back of the boat and push him so he goes the other way, not back to the same spot, and potentially spook the fish that are on that little rock pile. So get back at it, pick up my jig, open that line up, put it right back in the spot. Here we go. Ready? Is there a horse there? Where's the horse? Wow. Two of them sitting on one little spot. I can't tell you. Look at that one. Hey, how many are there? When you pop it in, swim it, and somebody finds it, he's gonna go in there because I do not want them spooking them. I'll put these fish and let them go in a second. You got a friend, buddy. They're not automatic. Get back at it. This is like cardio. Running, gunning, and catching. Gotta fix that chunk. See how it sits? Fish pulled it down. You know they're aggressive when they come out and even chasing it. But you catch one, you stir up the little school. There's a few of them there. They want it. And put it back. Check your braid. It's one thing about the spider thread. It's amazing, man. And put it back in the spot. See, there's a horse in there. Oh God, I can't believe it just got popped again. Here's something you gotta consider. See this? Look at that. Look at my chunk. But with the braid, when you set hook like I do, a little bit different from using mono or fluoro. Watch this. Get your pliers. See how that's bent up like that? Take it, just slowly bend it back down again so that gap is not really wide You want to get it in the top of their mouth, but you don't want it too wide where they can shake and come off. Where's the big guy? But it's about, 5.5, 6 feet of water here. That's why sometimes you gotta watch. Do not take your eyes off that jig. When it's in the water, swimming towards the boat, like that last fish, he popped it while I was swimming it. He probably followed those other ones out like a seagull, wanting to eat. It's amazing. I'm staying back. I know where the spot is. I can see it with the good glasses. I'm gonna dissect it. There's one, good one too. Look at him. You see what I mean? I think he's got it good there. That's what I'm talking about, see? When you find the right spots with crayfish colored baits, you are gonna potentially put fish like that in the boat. Well, there you have it, catching bass on the crayfish colored baits. Next time you go out, pick up some of the Strike King jigs, jig and chunk. Go to areas that you feel those largemouth and smallmouth bass are gonna relate to that are eating crayfish. Put these baits in those spots, fish with patience, concentrate on every pitch, do not take your eyes off those baits, and you're gonna catch them too.